Hey everybody, Allan Sanders here, and today we're talking about what it's like to fill in for a band. And recently I got a phone call about 10:30 on a Wednesday night, and this band said, "Hey, I heard that you play mandolin. Could you come play some gigs for us in Texas?" I said, "Sure, when do we leave?" And they said, "Tomorrow." I was like, "Okay, we're going to make this work." And actually I have another video on the importance of availability, so go check that out. But right immediately when I got that phone call, I knew that I had two priorities for that weekend. The first is to be a great hang, like be a fun person to be around. And it's especially important if you travel together, and nothing will test you more than being in the car for a long period of time with a bunch of dudes who over time will start to smell bad. You know, so I don't care how well you do on stage. I don't care how good of a musician you are, how good of a vocalist you are. If you treat people bad, if everybody hates you, if people can't stand you, you're not going to get called back, you're not going to get more gigs, and you're not going to have fun. So just be good to people. I think that's just a great principle to live by. And just be a good hang. So that's number one, be a good hang. Number two, put their mind at ease. What you want to do is try to fit into what they do. And you do that by your skill. You don't overplay, you don't underplay. You fit into what they're doing. You don't ask them to change what they're doing. And the last thing you want to do is make it worse. And so just be great at what you do and put their mind at ease. And I wanted to share a little bit of my experience with that band and going out with them. So here's a couple videos of what that was like. All right, here we are in North Texas. We're about an hour left of a 6-hour drive. Fun times. Hasn't been too bad of a drive, actually, so I've been pretty surprised. All right, here we are. We made it, finally, here at the Mitchell Resort in Perrin, Texas. And Bluegrass Festival is going on here. All right, so we got down there, and we got settled in, got a good night's sleep, and then Friday morning comes around. I was the last one up because I just like sleeping in a little bit, so slept in a little bit, and then we practiced for about 7 hours. And in between that time, you know, we had some breaks, kind of walked around, watched some people play, got a lay of the land, all that good stuff. And then that night we played the first show. And we got another good night's sleep, got up on Saturday morning and practiced for about 4 hours. And we played that second show, and I thought you might want to see a little bit of what that show looked like. So I downloaded some Facebook video. The quality is not the greatest, but here's a little bit of what it was like.
There's a path back in the mountain, one room house where I was born. Even now, the memories linger, my mama's smile so soft and warm. Lonesome night, I can hear it calling me back to my home, where the fox and hound soon. I'm gonna travel. calling me back to my home, where the fox and hound in the hills are roaming. Lonesome pine calling me home, where the fox and hound through the hills are roaming.
So after we played the first show on Friday, we practiced for another 4 hours. And you know, that seems like a lot, but we wanted it to be right. We wanted it to be good. And so we practiced for those 4 hours, and we made it happen that night again. And here's a little bit of the final show. Well, there you have it. That's pretty much always what it's like to fill in for somebody. And everybody always has a great time as long as you're a great hang and as long as you can put their mind at ease. And I'm so grateful to be able to get to do that almost every single weekend. So hopefully you've enjoyed this video. Hopefully you learned what it's like to go and fill in for somebody. And I've got some more videos coming out, so stay tuned.